All right, it's around 2 p.m. on a Friday. We just got our first Rover booking. Really excited to test out the platform, see how it works. And more importantly, our dog, Bo, is sleeping soundly right now. Bo, say hi to the camera. Good boy. All right, so a little bit on how the app works. Basically, they send you SMS. You get this little booking request with the name of the dog, the time of the booking. So this booking is actually for 2 days. You set your own rate. We set a pretty low rate just because we need to kind of build up reviews and build up relevance to be on the search page results. But yeah, so they've also put in any kind of considerations, whether there's like food allergies, special instructions, all that stuff. And then once that's all said and done, you can both confirm the booking. And then there's a possibility for you to meet the dog first if that's something that you want to do. Yeah, the dog looks super cute. Excited to meet him. And he is spending the night too, so we should be interesting to see how that goes. I'll keep you guys posted.
Okay, we just picked up Charles. I'm gonna call you Charlie. Hey,
buddy. A little bit of intros in it, but Charles is
showing him up. No.
I think I want to play.
Really? Come on, Charles.
All right, so we are at the dog park now, learning a lot about Charles.
So we just got back from the dog park and...
Now they're friends.
Yeah, now they're chilling. It was just the pent up energy. Oh, sit. Good boy. Sit. Sit. Good boy. Charles, you're a good eater.
Breakfast time.
Oh, come here.
Alright, off to go hiking. So we are off to Pacifica, take the dogs hiking. Hopefully they calm down some more, but...
Hopefully.
Yeah. I think this is the max dog limit a Honda Civic can take.
Started off right, I can see it in your eyes. I can tell that you want more. What's been on your mind? There's no reason we should hide. Tell me something.
All right, hike is finished. Two happy dogs. Hopefully some energy is gone, but so far so good.
So the trick we found is to keep them distracted. Now they're best friends.
Alright, so we figured out what is causing all the barking and provoking between these two. And it's honestly Charles.
Charles is provoking Bo a lot, and every time he goes near Bo and really pisses him off too much. Nope! There we go.
Good boy.
Good boy. And so now these two are happily coexisting as roommates for the weekend. No more barking, no more play fighting. All is good. We did it. They're best friends now. All it took was a long hike and some discipline. A little nighttime spa treatment. 5-star service right here.
All right, day two is complete. Two happy customers, ready to knock out.
Good morning, Charlie. You sleep well? All right, time to take these guys out. Okay. Charles, no.
All right, so we are taking the dogs to the park. Probably the last time we're taking them out, but just to get some of that energy release in the morning. These two definitely feed off each other's energy too, so it's definitely a lot in the morning.
The owner just texted us asking if she could pick up at 3 today. So originally he was supposed to stay till 6 or 7, so also have been sending some photos just to make sure she's always updated on how her dog's doing. Hopefully he's excited to see his owner. All right, Charles, it was a fun weekend. Time for you to go home, bud. Say goodbye.
All right, so let's take a look at some of the overall takeaways from this weekend. The first takeaway is that you really shouldn't expect to make too much money on your first booking. Like I mentioned before, there's a $25 fee just for running a background check. So you're already starting $25 in the hole. That combined with some of the other costs such as gas, driving the dog to the park, or driving the dog on the hike, treats, and any other costs that you really incur yourself, it really adds up. When we kind of sum that all together, we probably made around $10 to $15 for this first booking. The second big consideration is if you have a dog. So one of the lessons we learned is that having a dog can be both a positive and a negative. Charles was super sweet, but for example, he really wanted to play with our dog, and even when our dog was getting kind of tired, he still wanted to play. So it's definitely something to consider, and having two people in this case was almost necessary to kind of keep them under control and, you know, not let them get too rowdy. The second thing is that it can be a positive. So for example, some of the costs for Rover you would have incurred anyways. So for example, the cost of going to a dog park, the cost of going on a hike, these are definitely costs that we would have already incurred for our own dog regardless. So it can definitely help in that aspect. The third point is that if you live alone or plan on doing this by yourself, you can't really run any errands or make any weekend plans unless they are super dog friendly. For example, we found it pretty hard to just bring two dogs and go grocery shopping without having another person watch the dog. Or if you want to go on any activities with your friends that aren't necessarily dog friendly and you aren't just taking the dog for a quick walk or watching the dog for a few hours, you might have to back out of those plans. Given the current landscape, most of the activities people are doing now are pretty outdoors anyways, so it's definitely a pretty favorable time right now to be doing something like this. So, is Rover a sustainable side hustle? Yes and no. So if you look at the first booking in a vacuum, it's definitely not going to be the most profitable just because of that large $25 upfront cost that you have to pay for the mandatory background check. However, as you're able to increase your number of bookings, you're also able to increase your price as you're able to build a greater presence on the platform and get more credibility. Hopefully, you're also able to pick up a few repeat customers due to being able to build a great relationship. So for me personally, I'm probably going to rack up some more reviews and then hopefully increase my price a bit, as well as keep my eye out for certain opportunities that might make the most sense. Living in a tiny studio apartment, I think we probably would want to look for a smaller dog, a little bit more of a low maintenance dog. Hopefully you guys enjoy that video.
If you guys are interested in other videos related to productivity, self-improvement, entrepreneurship, and the life of a millennial, please feel free to drop a like and subscribe. Catch you guys later. Peace.